Blackstone Audiobooks presents The Lakota Way, Stories and Lessons for Living by Joseph M. Marshall III.
Dedication for Kimberly Jo Schmidt, 1972 to 1989. Daughter, granddaughter, niece, and dreamer. Here's to your dreams. And Joseph N. Marshall II, 1923 to 2001. Husband, father, grandfather, great-grandfather, and inspiration. Introduction. Let the wind blow through you. A playground dispute in the fourth grade concluded with a barrage of epithets hurled at me, each one more stinging than the one before. I was called every derogatory name for Indians that two white fourth grade classmates could remember. Stunned, I could think of nothing equally hurtful to throw back. That evening, still hurting from the insults, I told my grandfather about the incidents.
"Words can hurt," he said,
"but only if you let them. They called you bad names. Were you changed into the things they called you?" "No," I replied. "You cannot forget what they said, any more than you cannot feel the wind when it blows. But if you learn to let the wind blow through you, you will take away its power to blow you down. If you let the words pass through you without letting them catch on your anger or pride, you will not feel them." My grandfather's wise counsel has helped me through many storms in life. How his quiet yet powerful comments influenced me, and still do, is one of my favorite stories. When I tell young people how my grandfather's words helped me, I can feel those words going into their hearts. Stories and storytelling were all around me in my childhood. The storytellers were my Lakota grandparents, both maternal and paternal, and others of their generation. Strangely enough, these elders didn't seem old to me, but I did have a sense that they'd been around a long time and knew everything. If the storytellers were old, their stories were much older. The grandmas and grandpas were the living repositories for all those wonderful stories told them by their elders from generations before. The stories I heard and learned provide lessons that I can apply in the present, but they can also connect me to the past, to a way of life that has endured far longer than I can imagine, and to the people who walked the land and left old trails to follow. And because I and others like me were and are hearing and remembering the stories, that way of life will remain viable through us. I never tired of the stories, and I would ask to hear my favorites again and again, my version of watching a movie over and over. Those stories were not just of humans or two-leggeds. They were about other kinds of people as well. The elk people, the bear people, the bird people, and so on. And they were about the land. I never heard a story that didn't involve the land in some way. Everything in those stories is equally alive and able to affect everything else. A winter storm, for example, could have a personality. It could be impatient, pushy, broad-shouldered. A cottonwood sapling could whine and argue. The summer wind could be persuasive, enticing all the blades of grass to bend and sway in the same direction at the same moment. Those mechanisms in Lakota storytelling exist because the storytellers believe all things are related. I therefore look at winter storm clouds gathering or feel the wind on my face and feel connected to them. I don't regard them as something merely to plague two-leggeds. Stories entertained and informed, but of course, that was only their obvious purpose. Tales and allegories told by Lakota elders very directly enabled an entire culture to survive because they carried the culture within them. The stories I learned growing up were consciously told again and again to teach me about life, my purpose in it, and my path through it. These stories are certainly not random. Each illustrates a virtue that within Lakota culture is essential to balance and happiness. To the Lakota, virtues such as humility, respect, sacrifice, and honesty carry a different weight.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.